Recipe for Insanity. Written by Daniel J. Towsey. August 25, 2007. danieltowsey.wordpress.com. This may be the most difficult and important article I will ever write. If humanity chooses to ignore this one, then it will be over. Note, whenever you see the words you, your, in capitals, it implies a message directed at the members of the secret societies. All normal human beings are faced with the same challenges to survive. Hardships is what teaches us compassion and understanding. The struggle for survival is what makes us better people. Having to work to survive, buy food, for a shelter, and everything else is what makes us human and keeps us sane. We need limits. That is the only way to keep from going completely insane. For insanity is one that is lost in infinity. There was a time in our society not so long ago when individuals only prospered and advanced in society through good, honest, hard work. They were then respected for such. Long ago, politicians would only get elected for their uncompromising sincerity, honesty, fairness, morals and virtues. But now bankers use their money to influence and corrupt the political systems of democracies, and with the advances in technology, that which again the money masters have financed to create. They now control the voting machines and the results of such. Ah, but the insane think there is an easier way to do things. They have taken a shortcut. Unfortunately, there is quicksand along their path. And all who follow will also disappear into that quicksand. But just suppose you had an unfair advantage. What if you could buy anything you wanted any time you wanted? You had the money to control who gets employed and who does not. Who eats and does not. Who lives and who dies. You also controlled what they were employed to do. What if you had the never-ending supply of cash? What if you actually made that cash? You could also pick and choose who you shared that cash with. Also giving them a secret and an unfair advantage over everyone else. You would own their loyalty. Hence the secret societies. Your advantage would eventually become an unfair and overwhelming burden on all other normal humans. Eventually your free money would spread and spread. Eventually it would destroy the very structure of civilized society. Eventually you would be able to completely rape, abuse and destroy all of this planet's precious and delicate beauty. All that would be left would be nothing but ugliness. What do you see when you look into your mirror? Eventually there would be no reward left for anyone who was virtuous and truthful. They would be scorned, ridiculed and destroyed. For no one would believe what the bearer of truth was saying. Nor would they want to hear it. For life has become so abundant and easy at the expense of all others who do not have your unlimited advantage. With no limits of any kind, you would eventually destroy all morality. You would have no worldly limits. What would keep you from going insane? Without natural limits. What would keep you from making all of civilization completely insane? Nothing is the answer. With a never-ending supply of cash, eventually you would completely destroy the very fabric that keeps civilization functioning. That is the very dilemma that is destroying our very civilization right now. This is why we have secret societies. This is the secret they hold dearly and will kill anyone to keep it from being revealed. In a true democracy, secrecy would be outlawed. For there would be only one reason for secrecy. And that would be to hide wrongdoings. This especially applies to what they call national security. The only nationals that are being kept secure are the crooks. Now, with the secrecy that applies to intelligence agencies, why do you think they are called that? Because you do not possess the intelligence to know what they have been covertly doing. This does not mean you are not intelligent. It just means you cannot make intelligent decisions about the so-called intelligence agencies because you do not know what they are doing. They rightly should only be called secret covert mercenary agencies, for that is what they are. All this works on the pyramid scheme. To get to the top and stay at the top, you only have one thing to do, that is to deceive everyone. But eventually you would become just as insane as Howard Hughes became. The only thing a person who has become insane with money has left to do is play with people's lives. Since this unlimited money means there is nothing to keep you insane limits. With no natural human limits on you, you will begin to believe you are a god or an extraterrestrial, or whatever. With no normal human limits such as paying bills, doing groceries, doing laundry, cooking, shopping, taking care of the kids, participating in local civic activities in your community, paying taxes, etc., etc. You sit at the top of your Illuminati pyramid and play with your fake Monopoly money and play war games with your toy armies. You have absolutely no cares for anyone or anything, for you have become completely insane with power. With all that unlimited money. So you have used your armies to destroy anything that stands in your way. Thanks to all the power that your worldwide illegal Federal Reserve systems gives you, which you have placed in just about every so-called democracy in the world. It has been very easy for you to eliminate all that stands in the way of your complete insanity. Your biggest obstacle has been any organized civilizations or cultures, be they Christians, Muslims, Hindus, etc. Dear reader, please realize that all good and free democracies of the world were created by good Christians. But now what falsely passes as democracies really is not. Remember that whenever you're told that your government is bringing democracy to other countries at the end of a GPS-guided cruise missile or bomb. Repeating what I have said many times, you do not have a democracy if the people do not control the money, for the money controls everything. If the money goes into the control of a small secret group, society will always become unraveled and out of control. For such a huge responsibility must always be shared and controlled by all of us. Please remember everything I am saying here the next time you drop a bomb on civilians. I hope that maybe all peoples will start using the most powerful weapons of all against this most serious situation. The weapon is truth. And the most sophisticated delivery system in the world for that is free, and you have it. That is your words. Whether they be word of mouth or the written word. For the word is mightier than the sword. So are you now going to join the worldwide truth revolution? It's quite easy to join and participate. The organization is very simple. First you learn the very simple truths, for truth is always simple. Then second, you spread the truth any way you can. Remember, only deceptions and lies are complicated. If you do the research, you would find out that up to 60 million Christians of Russia were secretly destroyed behind the so-called Iron Curtain that you also created. After the Tsar and his family were killed by your covert agents. You then introduced something new to the world. You introduced communism. You then moved on to another country that had been peaceful for thousands of years. And introduced communism better. I am talking about China. the oppression, banning of religions, human rights violations, torture and murders that occurred after that are absolutely unlimited. But again, the truth never got out of the masses. As you continue to deceive them, nothing in the world could stop you, for no one who knew the truth would dare mention it. They would rather participate in it, for that was far easier and profitable to do. Plus, they got to stay alive. Also not known to most is you control all information that is taught in schools, or that is reported in the major medias. Was that the Nagasaki and Hiroshima nuclear bombs were dropped on defenseless Christian neighborhoods, and not on military installations. Let's not forget the non-stop firebombing campaigns inflicted on millions of Japanese civilians that you conducted. And now moving on to the Christians of Germany. You absolutely did not like their free democracy. You went on an unobstructed firebombing campaign for well over a year. You firebombed more than 60 towns, villages and cities. At night, for you knew that would achieve the most deaths. For they were all in their homes sleeping. Well, over 20 million defenseless civilians were killed. While your Hitler deliberately left the homeland undefended and went out to all surrounding countries and took over them for you. So that you could go in and put into place your monetary Federal Reserve systems, in other words, take over the money. Dear readers, you must understand that there is no democracy if the people do not control the money, for the money controls everything. How many of you readers ever wondered why it was that the Allies were siding with this so-called evil communist Russia? In the total destruction of Germany? It's not hard to figure once you realize that the bankers have been controlling both sides of all conflicts. They have been deliberately deceiving and killing you. As a result of the complete firebombing and destruction of Germany, all those other souls that were imprisoned by you in the concentration work camps, to keep the factories going that were fueling this war, Germany could no longer feed them. Months went by before the Allies came in to rescue and feed them. Meanwhile, typhoid caused by malnutrition started killing them off, as well as starvation. You waited months before going to their aid, as they were disposable, and to feed them would have been too costly. You later used this event as a cover and distraction to keep anyone from coming to realize your true intentions. You later created a whole fiction. Curiously, this fiction only occurred in the camps that were left in the control of the Russians at the end of the war. For you knew that the reporters from the still somewhat free West could not enter into Russian-controlled areas to investigate the claims. Is it not very curious that these fictions did not occur in any of the same kinds of concentration camps that remained under Allied control? That was because a ridiculous fiction would have quickly been discovered. But now that many years have gone by, you feel absolutely free to continue this very advantageous deception. Here's a note for you to think about. Before the war, there were 50,000 Jews in Palestine. After the war, there were 6 million. The Jews are also victims of the secret societies. The Jews were forced to relocate. Have you seen the pictures of Jews being loaded onto trains? The Jews that arrived in Palestine were forced to change their names so that they could not be traced back to Europe. The creation of Israel was not for the Jews. It was to create a base of operation to get control over Arab territory. Also, the 1.5 million German prisoners of war that were in Allied custody were killed by you. None of the prisoners were ever released. Dear reader, please realize that Hitler's dictatorship forced Christian civilians to become soldiers. The civilians had no choice. They were not willing participants. They were also victims of the secret societies. All conflicts have always been about the insanity in the bankers' minds. Let's not forget the Christians of Yugoslavia who were also destroyed through more of your propaganda lies. Again, you used your toys to destroy another decent Christian civilization. Again, you destroyed more than a million Christians in Rwanda by using your radio station to instill hate in the deliberately undereducated simple peoples by telling them lies. But in other countries that have been unified and strengthened through their collective religious or cultural identities, you have also gone in and very patiently seeded your weapons of destruction. In North America, you sent in your agents to destroy the Christian churches from the inside. That story you told to the public about 80,000 priests with molesting boys. Well, I just do not believe it, as there is no proof of it. Dear reader, have you not wondered why no priest ever went to jail? It's because the courts were instructed to be lenient on your agent infiltrators. Television has been your best propaganda tool. I also advise everyone to stop watching television and stay away from the influence of all other major publications. This includes Hollywood productions. People have been unable to come to understand what is going on in this world because they are using reason and logic. But they cannot even come close to the truth because the truth is not logical. For to go there, one has to open up their minds, and then in doing that you will be risking your sanity. For you would have to try and reason insanity. But there is no reasoning insanity. So most just completely close their minds because they do not know how to deal with this. For it is completely out of their range of reasoning, so they take the easiest way out. They just go into denial. But denial is not the truth, and without truth one cannot be sane. For lies equals insanity and truth equals sanity. What you have to do is accept the very simply truth of it. Once you accept the truth, then and only then can this madness be brought under control. But how many of you are willing to even ponder any of this? Is your life comfortable? Do you have a nice home? Do you have a nice car in the driveway? Do you have nice clothes to wear? Do you eat well? Are you caught in the banker's slave system of debt? I could keep writing until I filled books. But most people do not read books, as that would require effort. You like effort because the easy money has made for a lazy society. The secret society's entertainment industry has made people absolutely dumb. People do not question anything and never do their own critical thinking. The deliberate dumbing down started when you started to go to school. The first thing they did was to undermine the family and any teachings you received from your caring parents. That's why kids do not respect their parents or elders. Ever notice what happens to intelligent kids when they are in school? They get so absolutely bored with the conditioning, brainwashing, that goes on, that they cause trouble or get labeled attention deficit disorder. The secret societies have been deliberately drugging all the intelligent kids. The system is set up to deliberately destroy any intelligent freethinkers who under normal circumstances would become the leaders of the future. They get denied the ability to have a real education. I always say, never judge a person's morality and decency by their monetary standing. With enough research you would come to discover the absolutely horrible insane truth of what the money masters have been doing to civilizations all over the world. It's time for you to wake up. Only truth will give you freedom. Remember, freedom is never given freely. You have to protect and use your freedoms or you will not have it. The time has come to fight for your freedom. The only way to do that is with truth. So can I now call you a member of the Truth Revolution? We need you to be a truth soldier. If not, it will be the end. Follow a truth soldier on www.twitter.com/danieltowsey. Recipe for it.